Hi everyone, so happy you came by to see a new video of us. My name is Yanni. For everyone who is new here, welcome. And for everyone who is here already for a long time, welcome to you too. I'm so happy you came by and took the time to watch a new video of us. Today I am joining Jamie from Bored or Bananas. I found the title of her channel really so funny. I always makes me laugh when I see her channel name. So of course I joined Jamie in the Flip Over Friday. And of course I show you what I flip over for this time. And of course I will put a link down below for Jamie, her lovely channel. And of course I will put a link down below for the playlist for all the beautiful creators who are joining Jamie in this great challenge. So let's jump into our Flip Over Friday. So I'm back for a little while. I already saw the title. It is Flipping Friday. So I did flip off. I made a lot of things, but it is Flipping Friday. So let's jump into our video. So here you see my item I will flip over. It is a little, little boxes I use for my coffee and cream, I think you call it. Here in the Netherlands we call it coffee melk. And of course for my tea, these are two boxes of four drawers. So I put them together with some sticky gum. And you see here, I will take you close. They are in very bad shape because I used, I think, the wrong paint, and it's kind of a chalk paint, but it is awful. Everything is damaged, and I was thinking about it to buy a new one, but I give it one last chance, and I'm going to paint it in another color, and I hope it will turn out right. Of course, I will take off the metal handgrepen, zeggen we. Do we say here in the Netherlands? But at least the knobs that you take your the drawer out. Of course, I will try to use flip over this chicken. I don't like the way he's looking right now, so I'm going to try to paint this chicken also. But this is also an experiment. I don't know how the chicken will look like, if he likes it or not. So these are my two items I will flip over for this challenge. So you see here, I take my little wooden boxes apart. I already have the drawers out, and of course I take my coffee creamer and my pads for my coffee and my tea. I already have them out of here, out of the little dresser or boxes. I don't even know how you really call it. Here in the Netherlands we call it ladekastje. So I took everything apart, so that is will be ready for spray painting. So you see how bad they are. You can see now that there are two boxes with four drawers in it. So, and you see it really needs some flip over. So I'm really curious how they will look like after spray painting. So while my spray paint is drying, I'm going to do four of the eight drawers. I will do with some Buffalo Check print, of course from Google, and of course with Mod Podge. I will show that you in little pieces, so you don't have to look at it for a long time, because I know you understand already how Mod Podge is working. Of course, I did with some paper. I made this side clear. It doesn't look that way, but it is sandpapered. And of course I will do first a layer of Mod Podge on it, then later on I will do the Buffalo Check on it, because it is wood, it will first, I will, it's all the Mod Podge is will go into here, and the paper won't stick on your piece. So first I will do that and then I will do the buffalo check. But like I said, it's a lot of talking again. So I just show you what I mean. Here you see I already did one of the drawers. So you see already you have to dry still. But that's all four of them I'm going to make in this print. So I'll show you when they are finished. I show you how they turn out. So you see I did the four drawers already in the buffalo check. They are also drying right now. And in a moment I will go further with my chicken. He is now totally black. I think he already turned out quite nice. But I'm going to try to do a little creamy gray color over it. And then a little distress it a little bit. So a little bit of the black paint will come through. Of course I learned this kind of things from Yvonne from Ginger Chick Rehab. Because she makes the most beautiful things looking in the old feeling. So I am trying to do this also. I am hoping that it will turn out right, but we will see. So here you see how my black boxes turned out. I think they turned out quite nice. I really love them, how that they are now in the black color. I really love the matte tone of it and I really love it. So you see already, if I will do one piece of drawer in it, you will see how he will look like. Of course I have two for the plaid for this one and two of the plaid for the other one, and of course the hardware still has to go on it. So but I already love it how it looked like. So I think this really is a flip over and it was really horrible, but now he looks I think he turned out really, really nice. That's a lot of really, 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 really nice. Sorry. So now you see the hardware is on it already. And it totally changed when you do the hardware on it. I really love how he looks like right now. Of course, it is not an expensive little wooden box with drawers. Because he's from the Action, and of course it is not made like you would buy something very expensive. So you have to deal with it. Sometimes it's not quite the straight or something else. But for what there was, I think this drawer was only $2.99 for one block. And the other one is also, of course, $2.99. So for that money, it is really, it's from MDF wood, so it is a really nice little wooden box with drawers. So for the money, it is very cheap and I think he looks very nice. Now I'm waiting for the other two and of course of my chicken. So you see now the other drawers are also finished and I did them in a little bit of the silky gray color is the spray paint is called. And now of course I still have to do the hardware on it. So I will do that first and then I show you how the little wooden boxes turned out. And of course I will do my chicken and I have some here in the Netherlands we call it schuurpapier. And then I will distress it a little bit, the chicken, so the black will come through a little bit. So we will see how that will look like. So we are almost at the finish, how everything is looking. So now I have my hardware on my the last four drawers you see here. So of course they are finished. Now I will distress a little bit of my chicken. I don't know if it will go right because I'm not really an expert in distressing. Now first we're going to make our little tray. You see here, just a little wooden tray. I have a lot of them because they were only very cheap at the Action here in the Netherlands. Of course you all know it's a little bit similar like the Dollar Tree. Of course I will do this one piece of the print of my, at least if I am cutting right. Of course, a little piece here. So, of course, the measurements are very first do this one. You see how easy it is, like I told you in other videos also. It's so easy that you can make it any way you want. And it just gives a great feeling already. Just take a little print and just make it a little bit smaller, because I like that he is really stuck in my tray. And of course you can also mod podge it in your tray. But so you see here, of course you can stick it to the bottom with some sticky gum. But I'm really looking if I am, I think I need a little cut at the underside just to fit it a little bit better. As you know a little bit how I mean, of course I will do a little piece over there, but it takes too long for you. So you see here already a little piece of print, and already your tray is changing already. Now I have a garden bowl, at least a boxes bowl from IKEA. He was, I think this bigger one is $4.99, but you also have a little one. And of course I will pull the price off. At least I try. It doesn't work always that way. You see here, this is the one, the Vijkia, if I am correct, 18 centimeters, 7 inches if I am correct. Of course, just squeeze them a little bit around, and now I have just a glass dome, and I'm just doing my garden bowl. At least a little bit with, and I do place my garden bowl in here and just in the corner. And of course I will have my chicken over here, and I will do my chicken in here. And of course I will have some slices of lemon, and of course I think I will do some little piece of, of course you can do a little piece of hydrangea also here. If you think, now I like it a little bit more colorful, you can use any color you want. Of course I'm going this time for the neutral tone. And of course some, a little piece of distressed garland. So, but I just want to show my chicken if I want to show my chicken, so I don't cover it up in totally green this time. So I think it's just a little simple vignette, just a little distressed chicken, some beets, some hydrangea, and of course a little garden bowl and a glass dome, and you already have a little centerpiece for your own. For now I will do my little boxes over here. I will pull you up a little bit so you can see a little bit better. You see here, this is the first piece. So you see, he just fits under my upstairs closets. So I already have them over here, a little bit more to the side, and then of course my little tray. So in a moment I show you my little corner here by my coffee station. Of course, a coffee station is not a big coffee station because we just have a little corner on our kitchen counter. But first, when I do that, I want to say for everyone who doesn't like that my English is not really perfect, I really am sorry. I'm doing the best I can and I hope you don't mind it. I'm not coming up with the right word immediately, and sometimes you hear a lot of of course and go on and go on, but I'm really doing my best to get it more perfect. I already do it better than in the beginning, but for everyone who doesn't like it, I really am sorry and I hope you don't mind. So now, like I said, in a moment I show you my little corner, how he's turned out. So before I show you the complete end result, I want to say thank you, Jamie, for hosting this great Flipping Friday. I hope I remember this time correct, Flipping Friday. And of course, for everyone who likes this video and likes this content, I know it is a little bit chaos here always, all the time. But if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. We would love to have you here on our channel. So for everyone, have a beautiful day. Enjoy each other and please take care of yourself and take care of each other. And I hope to see you in another video. Love from the NME. Bye.